Hello, so we'll get to legendary weapons in this video, but after that we'll play a little bit more. I don't know, I want to see some of the things we have left to do. I guess we just have to conquer one or two more regions and then we're almost ready. Also, keep in mind, every weapon you get, every legendary item you get, I have a few of them. Some of them you probably have, some of them you probably don't have. Keep in mind that you'll be able to reforge them later, meaning you can reforge them to a higher tier, meaning it will be hard tier 2. Also, you can modify some of their, how should I say, their traits, their traits. So we can remove the base damage minimum minus 3 and replace it with something else. That will be better. But for now, we need to unlock the forge. Yeah. A lot of things we can modify on our gear. So for now, let's just go to Joss, where we actually will get the two missions. Well, I guess we'll take them on a leisurely stroll. Yeah, whatever. In Trust Village, you will actually find the two items or the two locations you need to start the quest for the legendary weapons. These items are, well, depends on how you look at things, but the shield at least is good enough for you to finish the game with. The spear, well, the spear I guess is good, but it really depends on how you build your characters or if you want to play with a spear. Mostly, you'll be playing with swords. Again, it depends on what you get, on what you have, on what enemies you fight. Also, I forgot to pick up a little bag over here. Hey, it's someone's lunch. So probably the easiest one is to just buy the wine. Yes, you have to buy the wine, take it to Lucullus in his camp. His camp, by the way, moves because he has its own legion in Asia Minor, so it can move just like us on between campsites. And then you have to go back to our base, and then
Fresh
you'll get
fish.
an item and a recipe, and then you'll be able to craft it. It will actually be a while until we craft it. The other one, it's kind of like a hidden thing. Sadly, they made a lot of mistakes while doing it.
Hello again. Glad to see you back. I know of certain recipes, the raisin wine, for example,
Or
or
the
the one
one
with
with
honey.
honey.
I have such ingredients in stock if that's what you're looking for.
Okay, so you can also make Passum and Mulsum by buying ingredients from her. Actually, I didn't cover this. I don't remember exactly where you do it, but you have the recipes. I think I had the recipe for possum. Broken sword, yeah, unique material. His family must have the schematics to reforge it, so remember, certain things you can craft later. So remember to ask when in Rome, ask for the schematics as well, again.
Hello again. Glad to see you back. I thought you might be tempted. My origin. Well, you clearly know what you're talking about. I'd be delighted to sell you a flower.
100.
Please do come back if you change your mind.
Exactly. So this is where you get the first quest item, which will be the rare vintage wine. Sanguis Jovis. Consul Lucrus will surely appreciate such a bottle. Yeah, he likes his wines. Now, as for the second legendary weapon where you start the quest, well, it's not so hard to see. Okay, let's come over here and I'll show you. You have to go and look in the tree. Yeah, I mean it, you have to look in the tree. I guess you can do this mission as well, but I already interacted with them, killed them once, and when you search the tree trunk over there, you actually get the symbol of the Warrior Stone Tablet. And yeah, whatever, you can read the story, but it says on the peninsula east of Troas where he fought and fell, find our symbol on a statue with a story to tell. Sadly, you don't get any quest markers, it doesn't even show up as a quest, but we'll get to the bottom of this. So let's leave. We'll go to Lucullus after we finish getting this item because it's the easier one to get. Also, it's not just an item, you don't get an item, you get, of course, the weapon, but you can also get some other types of loot. So I'll try to explain this, how the logic between this, but some of them don't have any logic. Peninsula east of Troas. Well, that's actually pretty easy because there is only one peninsula east of Troas. Right? The statue of the warrior. Mars or Ares, if you're talking about the Greek one, symbol of the warrior. Concealed compartments, small brooch, the second clue. The second clue is actually too abstract for people to notice. Turn south if your guidance is what you seek. Cross the channel and search the beach. Now this is a little bit weird because you might think, well, there's no channel. Actually, it's a channel, but it's in the south. It's actually in the southwest and it's over here. Cross the channel. I guess they mean the sea or what, wherever we are over here. And it's kind of hard to figure out in the beginning, but you'll surely find it sooner or later. I guess the clue is that you... Well, the harder thing about it is that... Where's the channel? Search the beach. The channel is actually... Oh yeah, okay. Laid to rest near the waves, beyond the mountain peak, shielding his grave. Gazing west at the birthplace of Thessaly. So it's waste, mountain and beach. Well, there's the mountains over here, and the only mountains are over here. So if he's near the beach, Valley of Floods. Sadly, you get a lot of injuries while traveling around, which is annoying. No, heal bestia. And Tulaf, I don't know, the injuries seem like they are all exaggerated sometimes, but I understand why they did it like that. Also, let's resolve this battle. And as you can see, he's kind of like our main leader right now.
We are ready to deploy the Legion.
Estudo. Oh, that wedge is very useful. I guess I'll have to use it later. By the way, one of my Praetorian guards is creating a lot of stratagems in our camp, in our base camp.
Ready to engage the enemy?
Enemy morale. Yeah, I guess that's one. It just throw the pillar.
Enemy equites are charging our formation.
Okay, let's do that one. Doesn't really matter.
Is broken.
Plunder. Well, I guess the looting will be better, but I don't think we'll go into the medium reward. Even so, at this point, I think you should just preserve your Legion manpower, since we don't have the option to increase our morale anymore. So getting more stratagems mean you not... It has its good side, it has its bad sides. You don't always get the option to increase your morale anymore, so yeah.
Falcies operandate!
So 6 and 6, we mostly succeeded in the tasks, in the roles. The Tomb of Achilles, it's actually pretty hard to find sometimes. Ah, you don't need them. I don't know why they make you take your companions with you sometimes. I think they should have just made it almost like a little bit of a separate encounter where you only enter with your... Well, main characters if they're available. And that's about it, but... Yeah. Actually, pretty nice place over here. I guess you can reload the encounter so you can get better loot, but I'll not do that. Add critical suffix. So as you can see, you can get a lot of affixes for your weapons, and that's how you'll modify them as well. That was actually a lot of food. Oh. Looks kind of weird. Thumbnail. 100 and... Oh, that's a lot of gold. A lot of dinari. Over here you can get some items, but I'm more really interested in the money. And then the main object, Spear of Achilles. And I think that's it, the only items you can collect are over there. Now, as for the spear itself, it's very weak in the beginning, so remember, you have to reforge it, you have to change some of its affixes, maybe, I don't know. Does it have any affixes? No, it doesn't. I'm not sure what the Reaper status effect is, since it doesn't explain to you. I guess we'll see it next time when you use it. It only has the spear, charge and the spear, pierce. Precise step. Okay, we'll probably reforge it and then we'll see how good it is. Now let's bring the bottle of wine to Lucullus. Yeah, it's a lot of work. To be honest, I think you'll need about 20 minutes to get all of these done. But probably the legendary weapons are worth it, especially if you are a collector like I am. Now, where is his legion? Well, you can go for the quest marker, but I think, yeah, over here. So, he does change his camp sometimes. still kind of far away if you ask me, but what can we do? That army strength is really big. Whatever, just give it to the fox. 20 ration is better than getting a lot of injuries. By the way, how is the triage going? It's going badly. Well, on the other hand, what will be the next region I will have to conquer? Oh, 4,000. And did they get so many reinforcements? Well, I guess they got the reinforcements when I was not looking. Sadly, this also means we cannot get our camp over here, so I guess we just have to go and garrison over there, so the attack will be a little easier on that side, since we'll have to manage our camp a little bit. And I don't want to walk such a long way. Okay, so this one is a little easier and a little more straightforward, but at the same time it's a little more complex since you need to invest more time. I think the second region of the game, Egypt, will be a lot easier for me because by the time you go there, you all have basically all of your armors, all of your weapons, everything will be top notch. I think you can do almost all the things in here except craft.
God, we're all women.
Oh shit.
It's not. Mark,
you did well during our
hello, my whiny loving friend.
That may be. Anyway. Really? Let me see. By Jupiter, we really must get you back to your father's vineyard as soon as this is all over. I know that feeling better than you might think. The best advice I can give you is to keep your friends close. This is a fine gift. When I think.
See you later, Patrone. Okay, now let's get out of here and let's go to our own camp because we have smelting and crafting to do. I'll try to deconstruct the spear and we'll see if it comes out better. Because usually when you get some items or the items you have already, they're a bit weaker than what you would get for normally crafting them later. So yeah, when we get to Egypt, it'll actually be probably an episode of only tinkering around with stuff and doing certain things. Nothing discovered, okay. Some weird legion, your legion travels a lot faster than your little party does. So if you just want to craft something and you feel like it's too far away, yeah. Okay, also I should look at what's happening over here. Manpower recovered. How strong is my legion currently? Well, it's nowhere near full strength, that's for sure. We might have problems sieging the last place. Well, I guess that's because I was releasing the prisoners, so I'd get the 10 extra morale points. But apparently, the morale points are not so cheap because you get a much bigger force to attack in one place. Sadly, we have to go all the way to our tent, see what's in the crate, and then go to the blacksmith. I think the developer should have just given you the shield. Well, I guess if you craft it, it will be on your tier or on your level, so I guess it's a little better. Correct. Thank you letter. It has been in possession for many years, solving a murder. The Aegis, the Shield of Athena. Gorgoneion, the head of the Mythical Medusa. You also have schematics for it, that's nice. So these are the schematics and this is the plate, the material required for you to make the shield. So yeah, remember, schematics first. I think it gives you a trophy as well, I'm not sure. Oh well, I guess the one available by default is enough. I haven't seen many things about the game. I don't think they will release any updates very soon because the game is very solid, but at the same time, yeah, there are certain parts missing of it. I mean, if you're playing on a lower difficulty, you will spend, 80% of your time on the overall menu. So craft the Aegis. Yes, assign a Praetorian. Are you the good princeps? I forgot. Okay, so decompose the spear of Achilles and then recraft it. As you can see, it's very easy to recraft these things. Oh, it actually looks very nice. Spearhead, ancient Greek spearhead. Oh, it will give us movement and critical damage. Okay, that will be a lot better. As for the other weapons, well, I have spoken mostly about them. I mean, there's no point in trying to reforge them a bunch of times unless you have the forge. Now let's leave and let's just wait over here patiently until that is finished. I mean, they are good weapons, I like collecting stuff. I mean, they had so many great ideas with the game, but sadly I don't think they went all the way with their ideas. They mostly have had to finish the game, probably. Okay, we're having some problems with our supplies. Mainly because, well, we just sold most of our food. So, okay, this is a very, very important tip. The way you make money in the game, most of your money will come from dispatching your legion to hunting grounds, getting the supplies, and then selling them when they're actually expensive. Or, of course, you can trade, let's say, supplies for a slave or stuff like that, but mostly you want to sell your supplies for a denarii so you can recruit more men to your legion. That's also a very important thing, because I thought you have to get the money from missions mostly, or the observatories. But no, you can actually get a lot of money just by selling your supplies. I think we have 4 hunting grounds. So when we go to Egypt, that's our main concern. Okay, so let's look at the items. As you can see, it might seem like it's not so good, but you have the chance to blind anyone who attacks you. Blinding means accuracy is set to 1 and 50% chance to miss. I'm not sure how much it lasts, probably 2 turns, I don't know. Now, a problem with that is that it doesn't have the shield crush ability, it only has the shield push. And it looks kind of small. So yeah, but you have the shield strength, which is not so important, fire resistance and maximum resistance. So overall, I guess it's a slightly better shield, but again, it will become much more better when you build a forge in Egypt. But now I guess that blending chest is pretty good and that... Ah, well, I guess the rest of the stats are pretty good as well, since I don't really tend to use the shield push anymore, because in the beginning, the shield push, what was it called? The shield crush was actually doing more damage than your weapons. Okay, what about the spear itself? Oh, actually, the spear is becoming quite nice. As you can see, it's 4 to 7 critical damage, 4 and movement too. So it gives you movement points, which is amazing. Now, sadly, it doesn't have the humiliating slash attack, which is one of the things I was waiting for. It only has a stab and a spear charge. 4 to 8, generate 1 focus. Yeah, I guess it's one of those weapons that you just have to keep until you can upgrade it, make it better. A lot of these items are super weird in this... when it comes to things like that. So as you can see, the Sifos level, the tier 2 Sifos, is actually better than a lot of weapons. 6 to 12. 7 to 13. Yeah, it's a good Gladius. 5 to 11. As you can see, the damage from these skills can be super... Well, I guess it can be intimidated, but again, you will sometimes want some utility, not just pure damage. Of course, other times you'll just want pure damage. Same for this weapon. I mean, that gauge is not really that useful. Okay, so that's kind of like how you get the 2 legendary weapons. We have crafted, we have done most of the things we can do. As for who will use the Spear of Achilles, well, probably no one, because it's pretty bad right now. Precise step cannot be blocked or resisted. Oh, that's actually interesting. So I guess you'll deal 4 to 8 piercing damage no matter if they are blocking or not. That's actually pretty good if you think about that. Well, I guess more or less, because you still have to go through that block if you want to attack with other characters.
Need something?
Another thing I learned the hard way is that triage is very, very, I don't know, it's very pointless most of the times, unless it's a very light wound. As you can see, you will probably have to put them in the triage since it takes way too long for them to heal without it.
Please, excuse me.
Now let's see how the trading is, because I want to conquer another sector by the end of the video. As you can see, the Denarii is pretty bad. To build upgrades and legend items. I'm not sure. I think it was cheaper the last time I tried it, so whatever. I guess if it's low, that means it's abundant, so you can get more of it. So 100 supplies, 100 rations is 1000 Denarii. So yeah, money is not such a big problem if you kind of know your way around it. Also, let's pick some stratagems. Engagement, enemy morale. No, I don't like risk to centurions. More loot, but scorched earth, no. Order retreat. So this will be available in future battles, but seems like it's a very bad one. Okay, one use only. Siege towers. Their defense, okay, that could be good. Enemy morale minus 40. Well, enemy morale minus 40 means 400 attack points. Where are my scorpions? I want to unleash the scorpions. Fortification. I guess we'll need some of those as well. Actually, let's take that one. I think the... Okay, this is not really explained, but you have four phases during combat. I guess engagement is the first one, and resolution is the last one, so you can use this in the beginning. Scorpion, I like the scorpion. And there are so many things they don't say, so... I guess this is the first phase of the battle, second phase, third phase, and fourth phase. So you might want to get cards that give you bigger bonuses in the beginning. You might want to get cards that give you more loot in the last phase in the resolution. You might want to get cards that save your manpower in the complications phase of the battle. So let's go over here to camp management. Upgrades. Yeah, we can build the palisades, but I don't want to build the palisades. I have the Emporium, which is probably why I have the better prices. So yeah, don't sell anything until you build the Emporium. You will have a much better exchange rate. Well, that's what I think, at least. For the forge, we need two iron mines and one farm, but we don't have any more farms left. We might have farms, but I don't think we have iron mines left. I will just have to see. This also might be good because you need to, well, on this difficulty you need to better manage your legion. Otherwise you'll just lose so many people in one battle that it'll seem almost impossible to replace them. Okay, now that we have become a great leader and possibly saved our legion from a lot of... Wait, no. I also said I'll recruit more legionnaires because I want to kind of overwhelm the enemy, not do pitched battles. Sadly, there's no way to reinforce your legion unless you visit the camp and the tent. I don't think there is a command for it, because I tried searching in the menu, the shortcut menu when you enter a camp, but it doesn't show recruit more people over there. Also, we don't have a lot of money, so I guess we can recruit about, 300, 400 more soldiers. These guys are very good friends, they are teaching each other stuff. Also, I think it's not really worth to recruit more people when you have all of the people you need. Shouldn't be using them anyway, so replenish. I need 4,000 dinari for that. Yeah, I forgot to check what my current legion, manpower is, but it should be okay. Okay, and this was the fun part of the game. Now let's conquer the neighboring region. Actually, before we do that, we might want to get more food. There's nothing we can do with our party anymore. I mean, we still have a few missions to do, but I'll probably do them in the next video, since I want this to be mainly a mission about the two legendary items and, of course, some camp management. I guess we can visit the observatories again, even though that would kind of put us at a big risk. 119 rations. Now, in case you're wondering, how do you see where the hunting grounds are? Well, you have to remember their locations. As you can see, that one disappeared. If you cannot access, access them, they will disappear. I'm not sure if the icon changes when you can access the observatory or not. Let's see. Cover treasure. No, I don't think it changes. So it's day 20, February 20. Oh no, not the bandits of Greece. Anything but the bandits. Oh, I can actually take a full party with me. Let's take another Sagittarius as well. Well, I guess we can do this battle, but from what I remember, these battles are really not worth doing because you'll get mostly injuries. I guess if you want to play Iron Man, well, I guess that would be almost impossible since... since you're put against a lot of people, so doesn't really matter how many archers they have. That's 4 people over there, 3 people over there. Maybe we can kill all of them. That's crazy, fat. This is crazy people talk. Okay, let's try to kill all of them, but again, I'm pretty sure that these fights are not... are not fair or well done. I mean, they have two archers raining arrows on your position, and you cannot go forward. And he's already panicking, so that means I cannot use his ability, that means we cannot kill this archer over here. Oh, actually she has a very bad bow. Why didn't I upgrade her gear? Target is in cover. Don't worry, we can do a lot of other stuff as well. Okay, remove his armor. I mean, remove his shield. Then knock him down, and then probably should kill him. Yeah, but I don't have Bestia with me, which is a problem. These guys look like they're not very well trained. Action, restore 5 to 11. That's such a high chance. Oh, we actually got the high roll. 3 to 4 or headbutt. I guess we'll have to go for headbutt. That's such a great animation. So 3 people are already hiding. But this guy... Well, I don't want to get constantly attacked by the archers from back, from behind. Not much we can do about it, sadly. that guy's already panicking. Okay, let's at least hide her so they don't have a chance to shoot her. Probably interrupt will be the better... No, interrupt will be the better choice over here.
Fight for your life.
Yeah, there's no way. If he panics while getting hit by archers, you cannot recover from that.
I think I can get behind them.
Eliminating all of the enemies is not such a hard thing, but yeah, it really depends on what your archers do. That's why I brought archers to kill the enemies. Blood.
Is that bad?
Oh, and we're fighting in smoke. That's actually super bad. Oh, he only has tactical, so I can knock him down. Times like this, I wish I had the slash that hits more people. I guess at some point I'll have to go back and try to heal him. He's also disarmed, if I remember correctly. Yeah, of course. Why wouldn't he be disarmed? The problems are so annoying sometimes. Okay, I guess I'll have to... You are missing a dead opponent. You are missing someone who is not going to fight back. That's such a big limitation. This is why I don't like to fight these bandits fights, because it's 100% not fair, especially because look at this. I cannot save my own guy because of the smoke, because you cannot kill someone, you miss someone that is knocked down with a sword in melee combat, I don't know. They should look back at some of these things, especially... Well, I guess we have to knock down him, you miss. Best should have done a lot of good work over here.
I'm done!
Oh, well, the archers cannot even touch my main guy.
Help me stop the bleeding!
Blood okay. Doesn't stop flowing on its own, you know?
I guess we cannot see them with our archers, so that means we cannot shoot at them. Cannot see target, that's one of the most annoying things I have made for the game. Smoke is not so bad, but come on, it's... so hard to get past it. Oh, you are disarmed. Someone disarmed you, because that's how the game works. Also, scaring them doesn't really work as good as before. I don't really see any other choice, since they cannot attack. 50% chance of hitting them. I guess they'll be able to resist a few more rounds. Wait, what? Death blow is not counted as a skill? Okay, fine. If it's not... Okay, I didn't realize this is not counted as, I mean, a weapon. That's again one of the bigger oversights. I mean, the developers have so many oversights. Why is death blow not counted as a weapon skill, but disarming him doesn't mean... Okay. So arches are completely useless when they are, of course, fighting people in fog, which should not really be the case, I guess. We still have the push available. Yeah, but that won't really work since we cannot go inside of the... I used the wrong thing. From what I remember, smoke will clear it out in 2 rounds or 3 rounds. Should I pull him back? No, I don't think there is any reason to pull him back. Also, I can kill this guy without any problems. Okay, so from what I remember, some of them are dead. Wait. Are they dead or not? Oh, I guess they're only knocked down. Do they have a Chiarius in their party? No, so there's no point in killing the knocked targets. Yeah, let's move over here. Maybe we can get another sneaky kill. As a matter of fact, we can. So... No, you missed. Cannot see target, yeah.
Someone here, let me take care of it.
I still don't... Oh,
it can't end like this.
I don't think it's healthy to bleed this much.
Okay, you guys will be fine. Sadly, I don't have a really good way of going against this. I could go over here and smash 2 of them, but actually I don't do enough damage to kill one in one hit. Can barely see what's going on over here. Wow, that... So he has deflecting. I cannot kill this guy. It's so hard to kill one character that is in smoke. It's almost impossible. I guess I have to... No. Maybe I just went too deep in their ranks because... Oh, okay. I guess I could also hit them on the stick. But I'm also bleeding. I don't want to lose him as well, so it's a lot of weird choices I have to make right now. Oh, whatever. It's not even the missing that is making me angry, it's all of the nonsense. I mean, Okay, they are hitting me. They hit me every time.
My next battle will be in Hades.
Tell me you can stop the bleeding, Medike.
Stupid. Just so many stupid rules in there. Okay. Can you tell me what your problem is? What? Why can you not go and aid him? Quietus. Well, I might have made a small miscalculation over there. Why can I don't understand this. Why cannot you... Another skill is active. Oh. Did I accidentally press that one? So she doesn't have the aid skill. That means I have to kill someone before I can move her. I cannot use a bandage because that will cause an attack.
I need some attention.
Okay, so how do I go around this? Because they have deflecting. He still has some shield left. I guess we can use death blow again. I also don't want to let that doctor go away. He might resurrect someone again. Kill him. Cannot see target. Cannot see target. There's no point in trying to remove. I guess I should remove his deflect because it's getting super annoying. Also, they have too much morale. I guess we can try to frighten them. Yeah, let's try again to frighten them. Even though I'm pretty sure they'll not run away. Inspire. He'll get hit if he does that. He cannot heal himself because... Maybe I should have healed him. Well, I guess hindsight is always the best teacher. Yeah, not much else I can do. Also, I wanted to clear out the spikes with him because the caltrops with him because he doesn't have a lot of health. Okay, that was actually pretty good. Not see target, so these two guys are in smoke. Yeah, she doesn't have her. Doesn't have her kick skill. Wow, this is super annoying. I guess we'll have to try it like this, and this is why I always put a weapon on my archers. It actually worked. Throw something. Well, to be honest, I don't really have a lot of choices. Wait, will that count as a flank? It should count as a flank, to be honest. I think they're adjacent. Cannot see the target even though they are adjacent. Cannot use that skill since...
That's too much blood!
Charon! Is that you?
Can you aid him again? Yeah, let's try that, I mean... That's another problem. I have to move to this square in order to... Okay, I'll just do it for the fun.
Come to my aid, you useless mules!
Mules. Okay, so he's stable right now. Can you use the... no. Yes, deflected. I don't have the knockdown skill, but I have the headbutt. Huh, I guess that's it.
I'm about to answer so many philosophical questions.
Yeah, sadly not all of them will be the right ones. I guess we have to remove your deflect again and then knock you down. Wow, these bandit fights are beginning to be annoying. Eh, we survived. Had to use our pila and we have a few injuries along the way, but... Overall, yeah, I'm happy with this mission. It's one of the first I actually finished, but again, there is so much nonsense in the game, it's almost unbelievable. Also, yeah, more loot for us. Iris equipment. I guess I already had that. Oxo. I didn't have that one. Oh, it's only a bad C4 and a few coins. Okay, we defeated the bandit. That was actually one of my bigger problems. And we didn't even have our main party with us. I mean... Yeah, everyone is wounded, everyone has a problem, everyone has to get better. Anyway, I think we'll just have to go to camp, heal out everyone, and then do another attack with our legion. Oh, that's bad. Can we go to another camp? Yeah, I don't want to lose anyone. Okay, let's split longer. Throw us. Well, he'll not die right away. Just a small gladius. A weak gladius. Shield bash, this is actually one of the better ones. I don't think I have shield bash on any of my shields. Wow, that's actually AP2. So shield bash applies exposed to self. Well, it's the same as the other one, right? Except you actually stun them. Oh, this is actually tempting, so you can shield. Come on, is it really that good? I don't think so. Exposed. Well, that only lasts for the turn you apply it in, right? That's actually a very interesting shield. Huh. I guess if you just keep looting on the map, you'll eventually find tier 2 items, which are much better than tier 1 items. Stat-wise, crit-wise, everything. I guess this should go into storage for a while. Critical, I guess it's in critical condition. Okay, let's enter the camp. Let's make everything right because we have a lot of work to do. Yeah, not so funny. Everyone got injured, but at least you got those bandits. That bandit fight has been the bane of my Asia Minor campaign since the beginning. You can escape very easy, but killing them is entirely another thing, especially when you don't have your main party active or available. So yeah, I kind of put better bows on my secondary archers. I guess it's not really about the better bow or the worse bow. I guess you can have the killer spear. Actually looks a lot nicer. Yeah, we need to do something about the shield. It only has two skills. Oh well, I guess it can remain the way it is for now. Okay, let's start healing people. Who's the extremely severe one? Critical hand injuries. Okay, I guess that's enough. What about triage? Okay, he has a bad one. As you can see, our medical supplies are actually kind of in a very, very bad spot right now. Okay, I think that's enough for today. Yeah, we finally beat those bandits, even though it was a much harder fight than I anticipated. But I'm happy with my progress of the game. Sorry this episode was so long, but I just wanted to get a few things out of the way, and then that bandit attack happened. Yeah, Insane is really not really balanced so much, but I guess it's fun. It's fun because there's no way to balance the end game of the game, so I guess, or the end game campaign for the first campaign, I guess they just put you against incredible odds. Before I end the video, I just want to look at one more thing. Where is his crit chance? Armor cap is 8, max here is 69. Well, that will not happen very soon. Main hand critical chance 12%. Main hand. Offhand critical chance is 16. I guess that's actually a very good critical chance. I'm surprised that some of the items are so good. I guess I wanted to give... Now whatever, I'll give the shield to him when he comes to his senses. Bye.